Hallelujah. The title of my sermon is Hallelujah. Come on, shout the word Hallelujah. I believe whenever you shout the word Hallelujah, I strongly say that something is going to happen in your life. Amen. You know, the word Hallelujah, we knew this word Hallelujah is very familiar in the church services. Also in the Christian world. Now everyone uses this word daily at least one time. Come on. You know, I use this word every time whenever I'm disgraced, so I used to shout the word Hallelujah. Whenever I'm blessed by God, I used to shout the word Hallelujah. So we're going to study about the word Hallelujah this morning. I believe you're going to, you know, understand the word Hallelujah better this morning, and you're going to praise the Lord by shouting the word Hallelujah this morning. As I was searching, you know, the origin of this word Hallelujah, the interesting thing in this word, it came from heaven. The Bible says, Revelation chapter 19 verse 1, this is the song of victory in heaven. After this, I heard what sounded like a vast crowd in heaven shouting, Hallelujah, praise the Lord, salvation and glory and power belong to God. The word Hallelujah, the origin of the word Hallelujah is from heaven. If you shout the word Hallelujah, heaven understands the word. Amen. Whenever you shout the word Hallelujah, God understands the word Hallelujah. The word Hallelujah has two parts. The word Hallel in Hebrew means a joyful praise in song, to boast in God. Hallel could also refer to someone who acts madly or foolishly. So Hallel means someone who acts madly, foolishly, you know, with the joyful praises of God. The second part of Hallelujah is Yah. Yah means the name of the Creator. Hallel means the song of praise. Yah means that is the Creator name, Yahweh. Hallelujah means praises to Yahweh this morning. So when you use the word Hallelujah, that is your praise to Yahweh God. Whenever people, children of Israel, they shout the word Hallelujah, Yahweh receives their Hallelujah shout. That is the praises of the people of Israel. And whatever the situation that the people of God is there, Lord, when they shout the word Hallelujah, God comes down from the heaven. Yahweh God helps them in the time of their needs. This morning, I believe you're going to shout the word Hallelujah. When you're going to shout the word Hallelujah, God is going to come to your life, and whatever the needs that you in your life, whatever the problems that you are facing right now in your life, and God is going to answer for that problem if you're ready to shout the word Hallelujah this morning. Hallelujah. We're going to study, you know, this word, and also from the book of Psalm 113. Verses from 1 to 9. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, give praises. O servants of the Lord, praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord now and forever. Wherever from east to west, praise the name of the Lord. For the Lord is high above the nations. His glory is higher than the heavens. Who can be compared with the Lord our God? Who is enthroned on high? He stops to look down on heaven and on earth. He lifts the poor from the dust and the needy from the garbage dump. He sets them among princes, even the princes of his own people. He gives the childless woman a family, make her a happy mother. Hallelujah. Amen. So this psalm starts with the word hallelujah and also ends with the word hallelujah. Now psalmist, he begins his life with praising the Lord and also he finishes his life with the praising the Lord. That is the Christian life. So when we start our life, we should start our lives with praising God. Everything that we have in our lives. We have good parents, we have good home, we have good job, we have good studies, we have everything. It came from God. God has blessed us with everything. So whenever we think all those things, the blessings that God has blessed with us, and we have to praise the Lord, we have to shout the word hallelujah, which means when we praise the name of Jesus, you know, he receives the glory and honor, you know, to his name. You know, Jewish people used to sing this psalm before the festival of Passover. The interesting thing is, Jesus also sang this psalm, you know, before he was going to the cross of Calvary. He used to sing the song, and I believe that Jesus also shouted the word hallelujah. Because of that, he overcame the death. Because of that, he overcame the sin. Because the word hallelujah has the power to deliver your life. The word hallelujah has the power to give you strength to your life. The word hallelujah has power to change the circumstances that you are facing in your life. The word hallelujah has the power to bring healing from heaven, from God. This psalm speaks about the power of the name of the Lord and the power of his throne and his kingdom, also his great love for his people. So we're going to study this book of Psalm 113 this morning. Are you ready to study the word of God? Yes. Amen. The word of God has power. The word of God is word. The word of God is honey. The word of God is hammer. You know, the word of God will bring healing to our souls. Amen. So the first one is, if you read Psalm 113, verse 1 and 2, let us all together read this scripture. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, give praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, now and forever. Everywhere, from east to west, praise the name of the Lord. So if you read, you know, from verse 1 to 3, all three scriptures tells about the name of the Lord. The name of the Lord to be glorified among the nation. The name of the Lord is powerful this morning. So as psalmist begins to praise God, he praises the name of God. In the Bible, in the Old Testament, God revealed his name in a partial way to their saints. God revealed his name, Jehovah. God revealed his name, Elohim. God revealed his name as Hail. God revealed his name as Jehovah Shammah, God of peace. God revealed his name in so many ways, and God revealed his name in book of Isaiah. You know, he is our Emmanuel. God is with us. So if you come to the New Testament, God revealed his name fully in Jesus. The name of Jesus has power. The name of Jesus, when we shout the hallelujah to the name of Jesus, you know, heaven rejoices. When we shout the name of Jesus with hallelujah, praise, hallelujah, shout, the hell will tremble. When you shout the name of Jesus with hallelujah, your sickness will disappear. When we shout the name of Jesus with hallelujah, you will receive the favor of God from heaven. So the name of Jesus has such a power to change our lives. You know, God revealed his full name in Jesus. He came as a human to visit us, to show the power of the name of God. So Matthew chapter 1 verse 21, the Bible says, and she will have a son, and you are to name him. Come on, shout him. Jesus. Name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. God has a unique name. That name is Jesus. The name of Jesus as power, the name of Jesus as healing, the name of Jesus as deliverance, the name of Jesus as everything. Whoever calls that name, the Bible says, they will be saved. Amen. Amen. So, we have the privilege this morning as God's children to call out the name of Jesus in the time of our needs. Whenever we call out the name of Jesus, heavens opens and God answers to our call. God answers and he honors to the name of Jesus. You know, the name of Jesus, God elevated that name above all names. The psalmist starts his psalm with praising God. Three times he tells that, praise the name of the Lord. All the nations should praise the name of the Lord. His name to be glorified. That is powerful name. That is wonderful name. That is glorious name. This morning, church, we have a wonderful name. That is Jesus. In his name, there is deliverance. In his name, there is miracles. In his name, there is signs and wonders. In his name, there is anointing of the Holy Spirit. We've been created to proclaim his name as the praises to the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whoever believes in that name, which is Jesus, they will be saved. To deliver the children of God, God revealed his name to Moses as Yahweh. But to deliver the whole world, the whole universe, God revealed his name through an angel, which name is Jesus. Come on, shout the name of Jesus. The Bible says every mouth shall confess the name of Jesus. Every knee shall bow down before the name of Jesus. Because that name has received glory and power and honor this morning. God himself elevated his name higher and he gave glory to that name. If you read Philippians chapter 2 verse 9 to 11, therefore God elevated him to the place of highest honor and gave him the name above all names, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue declare that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The only way to give glory to Heavenly Father is to confess the name of Jesus. In his name there is forgiveness for our sin. In his name there is deliverance. Because God elevated his name in the higher realms. So the name of Jesus protects us. The name of Jesus delivers us. This morning, I believe when you confess the name of Jesus, you will be saved. When you confess the name of Jesus, things will change in your life. When you confess the name of Jesus, you will receive the favor of God. The Bible says, call unto me, call to my name, and I will answer to you, and I will show the marvelous things to your life. To see the marvelous things over your life, you must confess the name of Jesus. That he is your Savior, that he is your Lord over your life. Proverbs chapter 18 verse 10, the Bible says, the name of the Lord is strong fortress. The godly run to him and are safe. The name of God, the name of Jesus is strong tower this morning. We can go and run and hide ourselves in that name. In his name there is protection. If you want protection of God or protection to your life, cancel all your insurance this morning. I will tell a new insurance. That insurance policy name is Jesus. Come on, shout the name of Jesus. Every incense will be finished in this earth. The only incense will enter to heaven is the name of Jesus, because heaven is praising the name of Jesus. Earth is praising the name of Jesus. Below the earth, someone is praising the name of Jesus, because God elevated that name in a higher position. Whoever calls that name, they will be saved. Whoever calls that name, they will be delivered. Whoever calls that name, they will receive answer from God. Whoever calls that name, God will come down and help in their tough situation. Whoever calls that name, whoever worship that name, whoever praise that name, whoever bow down before that name, God will lift up them higher position. He will forgive their sins. He will help them. He will redeem them. He will bless them, and He will use that person as a witness for many lives, because the name of Jesus has power. Hallelujah. Bible says every nation must worship name of Jesus. Every nation should confess the name of Jesus. Every king must confess the name of Jesus, because the name of Jesus has power. That name has saved you. That name has redeemed you. That name has blessed you. That name has healed you this morning, because you are here this morning because of the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus is glorified for forever and ever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, shout the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus is strong tower. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No one can touch your life, because you belong to Jesus. Church belongs to Jesus. Maybe Satan is trying to destroy your family, destroy your husband, destroy your wife, destroy your children. This morning, I confess the name of Jesus. Name of Jesus is strong tower. The name of Jesus is our fortress. The blood of Jesus is as power to cover our life, to redeem our life, to give protection over our life. Hallelujah. The Bible says, Romans chapter 10, verse 13. For everyone who calls on the name of Jesus, name of the Lord, will be saved. The Bible says Jesus Christ is the Lord, and He is the only Savior of the world. No one can save your life except Jesus. His name to be glorified. It name to be worshipped. Come on, begin to worship God this morning. Begin to worship the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are new creation to worship God. Thank you, Jesus. How should we give glory to the name of Jesus? When we confess the name of Jesus, when we accept the name of Jesus as Lord and Savior over life, we are giving glory to the name of Jesus. And also, when we tell Jesus to those who don't know Him, those who stand against Him, those who reject Him, that is also one of the way to give glory to the name of Jesus. Here in the Sunday service, we give glory to the name of Jesus by praising Him, by proclaiming Him, by telling all the goodness that God has done over life. That is the way to give glory to the name of Jesus. And also, we have another way to glorify the name of Jesus, is to tell the name of Jesus to others. Amen. Amen. This is our responsibility this morning. So when you tell the name of Jesus, that name has power to deliver you, to heal you, to redeem you, to bless you, to change your situation, and that person will receive salvation of God, and the glory of God will be revealed to that person, and the name of Jesus will be glorified. In Malachi chapter 1 verse 11, the Bible says, but My name is honored by people of other nation from morning till night. All around the world, they offer sweet incense and pure offerings in honor of my name. For my name is great among the nations, says the Lord of heaven's armies. You know, Jesus charged his disciples, go to all nations and proclaim my name. Proclaim the gospel, which is the name of Jesus, there is salvation. And when we confess that, when we do Lord's, you know, commission as a church, his name will be glorified in our nation. The name of Jesus is holy this morning. The name of Jesus is powerful this morning. You know, Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 10, the Bible says, all the people of the earth shall see that you are called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of you. You know, if you call the name of Jesus, the people, those who are living in our nation, they will afraid of you because you have the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You no need, we no need to fear for anyone this morning, church. We no need to fear for any kingdoms this morning, because our kingdom is never be moved, because our kingdom is never be, you know, shaken, because his kingdom is eternal this morning. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14, the Bible says, then if my people who are called by name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and restore their land. So, this is our responsibility this morning, that we must confess the name of Jesus over our nation. We must proclaim the name of Jesus over our nation. That is the, you know, witness, that is the responsibility of every believer who accepted Jesus as the Lord and personal Savior. John chapter 14, verse 13 to 14, the Bible says, you can ask for anything in my name, and I will do it so that the Son can bring glory to the Father. Yes, ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it for you. Hallelujah. How many of you are in need this morning? Lift up your hand and call the name of Jesus. The Bible says, you can ask anything in my name, and I will do it for you. The name of Jesus has power to help you this morning. Whatever the situation that you are going through right now this morning, church, you have a future. You have hope in Jesus this morning. The name of Jesus will help you. The name of Jesus will deliver you. And Jesus has one more name also. You know, if you read Revelation chapter 19, verse 16, the Bible says, on his robe and on his thigh, he has a name inscribed, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. His name is King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He's King above all kings. He's mighty King. Mighty to save. He is Lord of Lords. Our Lord Jesus Christ has another name. That name is King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. He is the eternity King. He is the King of Glory. He is King of Peace this morning. He is heavenly King. You may see earthly king, they will die. We have a resurrected king this morning who is seated on the throne of God. His name is King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Shout the hallelujah to the King of Kings this morning. He is righteous King. In his kingdom there is peace and joy. Hallelujah. Whoever rules our nation, I have a good news for you this morning, church. We have a king. He is the King of Kings. He is King above all kings. Every king of earth must bow down before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Because he overcame everything. He rules the nation. He has power to change the kings. He has power to pull down the kings. He has power to raise up the kings. Hallelujah. He is King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is mighty King to save our lives. Now the psalmist praises the name of Jesus. When we praise the name of Jesus, you know, he receives glory and also he helps us in the times of our need. This morning, I'll ask you all to praise the name of Jesus in the month of June. Whenever you feel disgrace, whenever you feel sad in your life, whenever you feel, you know, hopeless in your situation, praise the name of Jesus. Shout the word hallelujah, because the word hallelujah is praise. The one word can change your entire life. The word is hallelujah. The second one is the Psalm 113 verse 4 and 5. The Bible says, "For the Lord is high above the nations. His glory is higher than the heavens. Who can be compared with the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high?" The second one is, "The throne of God and his kingdom is greater and higher." God is seated on the throne. Jesus is seated on the throne, on the right hand of the throne of God. We have a king, Jesus. He is King of kings, Lord of lords. He is seated on the throne, right hand of the Father. He is interceding for us this morning. He's not only king, he is a high priest. He is interceding for our lives. He is interceding for our sins to be forgiven. Though he is king, he is interceding for us as a priest. The second one is the throne of God and the kingdom of God is greater and higher. We belong to his kingdom. We have king over our life. He always, you know, protects his people. He always leads his people toward the righteous way. He always helps people in the times of needs. He always feeds his people, you know, every day. He always gives his righteousness to his people. Because he is the righteous king, as we believe his name, when we believe his name, he gives his righteousness to our lives. You know, Isaiah chapter 6 verse 1, the Bible says, "In the year that King Uzziah died," you know, every king of earth will die one day. Hallelujah. Uzziah died. You know, from Uzziah, Prophet Isaiah received many favor from him. But that favor stopped because the Uzziah king died. You know, if you believe earthly kings, they will die surely. You will no longer receive favor from them. But I'm going to introduce King of Kings this morning, Jesus. If you believe him, if you trust him, you will continuously receive grace and favor and the glory over your life. "In the year that the king Uzziah died, I saw the Lord high and exalted, seated on a throne, and the train of his robe filled the temple." And Isaiah saw the vision that Lord seated on the throne. Not only he is King of Kings and he is seated on the throne, he is still seated on the throne, he is ruling his people. Though we are living in the nation of India, but we have a king, his name is Jesus. He is ruling over our lives. He is protecting over our lives. Because he is seated on the throne, still he is ruling. His kingdom never be shaken. His kingdom never be moved. The Bible says, Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2, "Fix our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and the perfecter of faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God." Jesus is seated on the right throne of God this morning. He has kingdom. We are his kingdom. We belong to God's kingdom this morning. Whoever accepts Jesus Christ, whoever washed by the blood of Jesus, we are belong to God's kingdom this morning. We have king. His king's name is Jesus. He is ruling our lives. He is seated on the throne this morning. He is ready to help to our life. His throne is never be shaken. Isaiah saw the throne of God and he shouted, "Lord, I am nothing before your throne, before you. And he praised God. He worshiped God. He saw the throne of God. Jesus is seated on the throne of God this morning. And Isaiah writes that his presence, his robe is filled with his temple. Bible says, we are the temple of God. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is living in us. I believe this morning the King is seated on the throne, Jesus. We are the temple of God. We are here to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. As Isaiah saw that this robe was filled with his presence, with his mighty power, as you are seated here this morning, praising the name of Jesus, praising your King of Kings, I believe the power of God fills your life. The presence of God fills your life. The peace of God fills your life. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. We are the temple of God. And also the Bible says, if anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy the person. Hallelujah. We fear for humans. We fear for, you know, the people. They will attack us. We are church. They will attack us. They will bring, new laws against us. But I have a good news for you. We have a King over our life. And we are his people. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Whoever touches our life, God will destroy that person. God will destroy that kingdom. Because we are belong to his kingdom. The speciality, in his throne is found in the book of Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16. As we read this scripture. So let us come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. There we will receive his mercy and we will find grace to help us when we need it most. So the psalmist praises the name of God. The name of God is King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who is Jesus. He is seated on the right hand of the Heavenly Father. And he is king over our life. He is ruling our lives. And Isaiah saw the King of Kings on the throne of God. And when he saw the king, his robe was filling, the temple. His presence was filling the temple. His glory was filling the temple. And we are the temple of the Holy Spirit this morning. As we worship the name of Jesus, he is seated on the throne. He releases his grace and presence, favor over our lives. And in his throne, we can find grace and mercy of God to our lives. So the author of Hebrews, he writes that, come boldly to the throne of God to receive the favor and the grace and the mercy of God in the time of our needs. How many of you need favor of God over your life this morning? How many of you need the mercy of God this morning, church? If you want the mercy and the grace and the favor of God, let us all together boldly go near to the throne of grace by the name of Jesus. We will receive the grace of God, the favor of God over our lives. So psalmist praises the name of God. He praises the name of Jesus. And also he knows that he is the king over all kings. He is king over all the nations. He rules everything. So in that chapter, the third thing, it speaks about the great love. The love of God is so great and higher for humans. If you read Psalm 113 verse 6 and 9, the Bible says, he bends down to look at heaven and earth. He lifts the poor from the dust. He lifts the needy from the garbage heap. He sets them with influence people, with influence leaders of his people. He makes a woman who is in a childless home a joy mother. Hallelujah. From verse 6 to 9, that speaks about the love of God is great and higher. The first one is the name of God is great and higher. The second one is, he is the king. So he is, his kingdom is great and higher. The third one is, his love is, love of God is great and higher. The scriptures talks about how much he loves people. He came down from heaven, though he was king, though he has power, though he has glory, though he has everything, he left everything. He took a human form as a man, man of slave, came down from heaven to seeking you and me to tell the love of the Heavenly Father. The only reason that Jesus, he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, he is God, he is the creator of the whole universe, came down from heaven to tell us how much Heavenly Father loves you. So these three scriptures tells about the love of God is great and higher. His name is great. In his name we find protection of God. His kingdom is great. In his kingdom he is king. Not only he is king, he has made us to be the kings and the royal priesthood in his family. We are kings, amen. We are priests this morning. We are the temple of God. His presence fills his temple. His glory fills this temple. The very purpose that Jesus came to this world is to tell us about the love of Heavenly Father. So, the second part of this psalm is, you know, the love of God to the human beings. So we're going to study about the love of God this morning. Are you all happy this morning? How many of you blessed by the word of God? Amen. Give him the round of applause to Jesus this morning. Now, as you read this scripture, we're going to study about one by one. The first one is, which is fourth, is in his great love to save all the people, he humbled himself. Amen. So the psalmist gives glory to the name of God, and he understands that he is king over all kings. And to show the love of God, he came down from heaven as a human. He left everything. And the scripture says, tells that, Psalm 113, verse 6, he bends down to look at heaven and earth. What does the Bible tells? He bends down, which means he came down from heaven as a human. He humbled himself to seek the fallen generation, you and me. He humbled himself. Humbleness means to lift up the fallen generation. The next scripture says that he lifts the poor and places them before the kings, before the princes. That is the great love of God. We are sinners. We were died in our sins, in our iniquities. Jesus came from heaven. He shed his precious blood on the cross and he washed us. And though we are died in our sin, though we are poor in the love of God, he came down from heaven seeking us to help us, to redeem us, to lift up our lives from our mighty clay, lift us from our sinful life. It shows his humility by seeking the fallen generation. The psalmist, he writes that he bends down to look at heaven and earth. Philippians chapter 2, verse 7 and 8, the Bible said, instead, he gave up his divine privileges. He took the humble position of a slave and was born as a human being. When he appeared in human form, he humbled himself in obedience to God and died a criminal's death on a cross. What a loving Savior we have in our lives. Hallelujah. Come on, shout the word hallelujah. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus has power. He is king over all kings. He is king over all the nations. His love is great. To show his love, he left all his privileges, divine privileges. He left his glory, he left his power, he left all his authority, he left everything. He came down from heaven as a human to show the love of God to each and every one of us whoever believes the name of Jesus. He bends down from heaven to earth to see the fallen generation. Hallelujah. He humbled himself, the Bible says. You know, the humbleness means not wearing a white dress. You know, not shaving your, you know, mustache. Humbleness means to lift up the fallen generation. Church, there are so many fallen generations are there in the city of Coimbatore. There are so many fallen people are there in the nation of India. How the King of Kings came down from heaven to pick you from your fallen place. We are the King. By his blood, we have the work, we have the responsibility to help the fallen generation to lift up their life from their fallen places. Hallelujah. So that's what the Bible says. No, verse 7, the fourth one is, he lifts the poor. He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the needy from the ash heap. So the people of Israel, they were a very small nation. You know, they were slaves for 70 years in the land of Babylon. They were begging for food, you know, because they disobeyed God, they disobeyed the law of God. So God handed them to the nation of Babylon for 70 years. The 70 years, and they, you know, they were God's people, but because of the oppression of the kingdom of Babylon, and they become a small nation. They become poor. They don't have food to eat. So when they cried out the name of God, and God helped them, God delivered them from their slavery. So this morning, we have a good Savior, Jesus Christ. He lifts up the poor, you know, from the miry clay, and he sets their feet on the rock this morning. Psalm 44, verse 25 to 26, the Bible says, for we sink down to the dust, our bodies cling to the ground. Rise up, come to our help. Redeem us for the sake of your steadfast love. Because of his love, he redeemed us. Because of his unfailing love of God, God sent his only son to this world. His son, king over all kings, king over nations, king over the skies. He came as a human form. He humbled himself, the Bible says. He took on a human form. He lost all his privilege to give the love of God to each and every one of our lives. And we were poor in spirit, which means we did not have hope for salvation. We are poor, and he came seeking us to give hope of God through his blood, salvation, by giving his salvation to each and every one of our life. The Bible says, Matthew 5, verse 3, blessed are the poor in spirit, for there is the kingdom of heaven. You know, I already said that we belong to the kingdom of God. We belong to King this morning. So blessed are those who are in, you know, blessed are the poor in spirit, which means those who do not know Jesus, they are poor in spirit. Those who are in the need for salvation and the forgiveness of God and the peace of God, they are poor. Jesus came to seeking them to give peace of God, forgiveness of God, and also the blessings of God over their life. Amen. So, the second part, the psalmist says that is great love towards human. So, to show the love of God to the humans, he left all his privilege. He came down from heaven and he lifts the poor from their poor places, from their fallen places. And the next one is, the Bible says, Psalm 113 verse 7, He lifts the poor from the dust and He lifts the needy from the garbage heap. The second one, the next one is, He lifts the needy. So this morning, you may be expecting blessing from God. So you may be praying for the need for your life. Jesus lifts you, the needy people. Jesus helps you in your need. Jesus helps you, you know, feeds you with His precious food, precious bread. So I want to conclude my message by saying this. The seventh one is, the final one is, He sets the poor and the needy among the princes. The word says He sets the poor and the needy among the princes. Though He was king, He came down from heaven seeking poor, you know, helpless people, and He helps that people and He makes them to be princes and the leaders over many nations. Hallelujah. That is the testimony of King David. He came to seeking King David. He was a, you know, simple shepherd boy. He was in the wilderness, you know, shepherding all the sheep that his father gave to him. And God was seeking him, and He came seeking him to anoint him to be the king over the nation of Israel. So this morning, I believe God is going to anoint someone this morning. God is going to use you for His purpose this morning, church. Because He sets the poor and needy among the princes, the Bible says. Who is prince? My son is prince. And also, Jesus is prince of peace. Jesus is the leader. He is a captain of our salvation. He came down from heaven seeking fallen generation to show the love of God, and He became just like one of them, and He left every privileges, divine privileges. He lived with them, and from their poor, you know, condition, He helped them. He gave salvation. He gave love. He gave the grace of God. He gave the favor of God. He gave everything. He gave His life also. And He lifted them higher, and He placed them over prince. The prince is Prince of Peace, Jesus Christ. So we have the privilege as God's people, and we are seated next to the King of Kings this morning, the Lord of Lords this morning. Hallelujah. He raised us from our dead, and along He seated us with His heavenly realms, the Bible says. Finally, you know, Psalmist finished by saying this, verse 9, He gives the barren woman a home, making her the joyous mother of children. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He gives the barren woman a home, the Bible says. Who is the barren woman? Here, God is telling the nation of Israel is barren woman. There is no childbirth in the nation of Israel because they were slaves in the land of Babylon. They lost their, you know, God's blessing because they disobeyed God. You know, God turned His wrath over them. They lost everything. They lost every blessings. The children are God's blessings, the Bible says. They lost that also. But the Bible says, in verse 9, the psalmist praises God. He gives the barren woman a home. This morning, God is going to bless you a baby. Maybe you've been praying for a long time to have a baby. God is going to answer this month. Hallelujah. God is going to hear your prayer this morning, church. You know, today the churches are in barren condition because not spiritual birth among the churches, among the nation. I believe time is going to come. God going to release, you know, the children, kids, to the church. No, they are God's children. They're going to rule the nation in our nation. Amen. So Bible speaks about three houses. One is God's house, Psalm 69 verse 9, the Bible says God's house. Isaiah 56 verse 7, the Bible says, my house is the house of prayer. And John 14, 2, Jesus says that, in my Father's house, there are so many rooms, I'm going to prepare a place for you. The house speaks about the heaven. He visits the barren nation, he visits the woman, barren woman, and gives them a home. Which means he visits the barren church, barren woman, barren nation, and he gives spiritual birth to the churches, to the nations, and then he lifts up them and he will bring those people towards his house, which is heaven. That is the praises of Psalmist this morning. Hallelujah. So he praises the name of God. The name of God fully revealed in Jesus. And he praises the greatness of his kingdom. And also he praises his greatness of his love. And his greatest, that the love of God was seen through Jesus Christ. Jesus left everything, every privileges. He came down from heaven seeking the poor people, needy people. And he lived with them. And he poured out his life with them. And he lifted them higher and placed them before kings, before princes. And also finally, Psalmist finished that. And he gives, barren women a home. And he builds the home. And he brings all those people, those who are poor in spirit, to the heaven. What a loving Savior we have. What a loving God we have. Come on, shout the word, hallelujah. So whenever you shout the word, hallelujah, you are shouting the name of Jesus. You are shouting King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You are shouting the kingdom of God. You are shouting that God lifts me in my poor condition and he placed me before the kings and princes. And also he gives, barren woman a home. And he gives spiritual children to the house of God.